We are working on an 87 Mercury Cougar. I've had this car for about 18 years. My first car I got in high school. We're at my shop today with our handy assistant Savannah. Good day, Savannah. Savannah's got to go clean her toolbox and get her tools ready to work on her future's car. Today we're just going to get to be driving around for a little bit. It's been sitting for quite a while. Backdoor project. Since all the children came home. But now the children are almost old enough to drive. Everything under here looks pretty good. I've built this whole car many times, so I pretty much know the ins and outs of it. Got a little bit of rust working in the trunk today. I'm not really happy about that at all. But I can fix it. And I'm not happy about the brand new tires I put on it that are now dry rotted.
Seriously?
Yeah, we got to put tires on it again. But that's what happens when you let stuff sit. $800 in tires. And rims. That was the cost of the rims too. These tires probably have less than 300 or 400 miles on them. And I need one of these, if anyone out there knows where we can find one. I used to have a million parts for these cars back in the day, and now they're hard to find. Old 351 Windsor in there, holding up pretty good. This motor came out of a 69 Cougar convertible XR7. And I stuffed it down in here, and we gotta get struts, I'd say. Shock struts, tires. I'm gonna take these out. I totally forgot they were in there. They've been in there for 17 plus years. That was back when I had bigger rims on this car. But we're gonna get her down off the lift now and check out the lights and make sure all the lights work and it's safe to be driven so we can iron things out as they come along. So join us in a few minutes as we continue on the resurrection of Christine, the mighty 87 Mercury Cougar. I'm trying to bring it back to life. Time to cut the old coil spring spacers off.
Yeah.
Put safety first.
He's doing it now. Yeah.
Yeah.
Do it.
Doing it. I need a flashlight. Safety first.
We want you to like the video.
Share and subscribe.
Send us money because we want to restore this classic.
Classic.
Yes.
My classic.
Yes.
Butter. back. Alright, don't do anything yet. Just take your foot off the brake. Easy. You're gonna go. Don't give it no gas though. There you go. Keep your foot close on the brake. Turn the wheel to the right just a little bit. There you go. Alright, let off your brake. Let off the brake. Slow down a little bit. There you go. Wheel to the left of here. Left. There you go. Straighten it up. Cool. Alright, hold on. Slowly, let your foot off the brake. Keep it straight. Well, that's good. Put it in park. Put it in park. Take your shifter and go up. Just keep it for the brake. Go up again. All right, hold on. Push the red button up. There you go. Now go up again. Up again. Up. There you go. That's park. Other way. Good job.
I knew that.
First time driving. All right. You've done good.
Not necessarily my first time.
Hey, yeah, roll your window up before you wash it. Right here. It's not power, honey.
Oh, it's not?
No. Old school.
Old school.
All right. Is your key off? Take your key off and lay it in the seat. There you go.
Yeah.
Now wash her up for me. Yeah, I'll shut this. High five.
Woo! Woo! That was fun.
It's dirty from sitting. These seats are actually out of JFK Jr. Jr.'s turbo coupe. I bought it wrecked at an auction a few years back. I had all the paperwork and everything to go with it. Ended up carting the car out. I'm gonna save the seats. So, yeah. A Kennedy sitting in this seat.
Probably had a
Kennedy hooker over here in this seat. Maybe some Kennedy drugs. Not that I know if they've done any of that. I'm just speculating. Purely speculation at this time. Heck, maybe even a Kennedy was conceived in the back seat here. Who knows? I got them front cool spacers out that I totally forgot were even on the car. And I love the way it's sitting right now. I'll get a better shot later when I get out of the shop. But I got her cleaned up a little bit today. Got the taillights working. My Freebird Automotive sticker on. Kids washed the car. I wanted to realign the hood. I don't think I'm going to keep this hood anyway. It's never really set well with me. People have their opinions, and I kind of really don't like it either. But I built it. I'm guilty. It's definitely different. I'll give it that. I'm not going to knock my artwork. But I think I'm just going to go back with the turbo coupe hood. Maybe take that spoiler off the back and just go for it.
sleek look. Can't speak right now. Gonna have a heat stroke. The only time I ever put the car in my garage, something fell on it. Cool. Stay tuned, Free Birdians, until next time.